So I absolutely love to do the next section. We're going to go through a really new way to do a thing, to extract the drawings in Rhino 8, which is actually you extract vector drawings in Rhino. You can think of it like make 2D that is dynamic, update with model changes. And it actually take into account the sections and everything that you do there. So the next tutorial is for us to go through and try to extract plans, elevations, and sections with and without background information, all created as a vector, flat vector drawings projected on the XY plane. That we can see it in model space, but we also can zoom to it in layout space. So this is what the next tutorial is about. So let's jump right into it. Let's go to open, and we will open exercise 6, which is sections drawings. This is a slightly bigger model, just so that to show you that we can handle different level of complexities here. This model is a twin townhouses. Mary put together that model. I added a few details to it to make it kind of resemble a real building in terms of scale and details and all that. But I have all the styles and everything, all the section styles already set up, all the details set up, so that all we need to do at this point is to extract the drawings. But this is a really nice example, like modeling example in general. And as you can see, I have an south elevation clipping section to represent that. I have a section 0, 0 here, which is sections, which is what's active in this view, and I have a plan view as well, which is on the setup on the second floor of that building. And what we will be doing is extracting the drawings of this building. So the command to do that is under drafting sections, create drawings. So you run that command, or you can type the command in the command line, and then select our section 0, 0. Okay. And press enter. And let's make sure, as you can see, you can like change the angle. You can set the print width by the input object or by the layer that you will put your output in. You can also change the display color also by the layer or the objects that you have cut it through. You can decide to show the hatch or not. You want to show the solid, which it creates basically planes that fills, but it's actually NURBS surfaces that actually fills that particular section, and it actually is assigned the same material of the object they cut it through. And you can add the background. Let's just set up add background for now to no. And just we are at this point only extracting the sections themselves. We can show the label to know what is our drawing is, the label style apply to all. We already selected only one. And at that point, I'll just go to the top view and place my drawing anywhere I want on the XY plane. So I can just pan a little bit, put it somewhere out there, and press on that particular point. What you see here is my section has been extracted along with all the details, all the hatches, everything is a vector drawing. And if you look at the layer, you will see that we have created a new set of layers under the title, which is the name of the section itself, section 00. I'll drag a little bit so we can see. And this is where the drawing is, where the curves and the hatches are there. You can like turn off the hatches if you will layer, or turn it on. But you can turn off the section, all the section itself or not. Now all the data is organized in layers, and by default, all the layers are locked because this is going to update dynamically with model changes. You typically don't want to touch and change this because any changes you introduce, they're going to be updated and wiped off typically. But it is organized in layers following similar style to Make2D. They are locked, but they allow you the possibility to turn off and on some layers in modeling a space and layout a space, give you that level of control. That's available to you that way. Now, if I go to my model and let's say I drag my section so that it actually cuts it through the stairs, you will see that my section here at the top view updates to reflect that change that has been made. And this is really nice facility that you have here, that basically you can dynamically get those. I'll just for the sake of the class, I'm just gonna, you're not, you know, we typically don't want to do that, but let me just unlock to show you that everything here is just curves and hatches, and it's just a vector drawing. Like any other drawing, like any other geometry in Rhino. I'm just gonna put that back, go to the default. This is nice because what you can do also if you add a layout, and I'm just doing the basic thing here. The details will follow. But if I add a detail here, I can just go directly zoom to my section and show that in layout. And basically, if I don't want to see it in modeling a space and only want to see it in layout a space, I can just basically you will see that all that section 00 layers, I can turn them. In model, I can turn them off in model space and in model space, but they stay on in layout space. So now I'm no longer, if I don't want to show it, see the top view? There is nothing here left of that because I turned it off, but I can turn it on again. So this is an organizational ability. Now it's independent. If you want to show it only in model space, you can. If you want to show it only in layout, if you want to show it in both, that is up to you. And it is now updatable with model changes. So if you add objects, if you change your clipping a plane, it's going to update. So this is extremely nice. I can also extract the elevation. So I have my south elevation that's only cutting through the base here. But what I need to do is not just extract the section. I should extract the background. So why don't we do that first? For that particular section 00, let us turn on the background. The way to do that is at the time of creating the section, but another way is under drafting, go to sections and say edit drawings. Edit drawings is basically. Okay, I pre-selected the south elevation. So let me just be sure I have ability to do that. Edit drawings. Select the clipping plane. We'll select the section 00 plus enter. You remember in that option we turned off the add background. Now I say, no, actually, I want to see the background. I want to see all the lines in the background, and I want the projection to be parallel. And I want to see the hidden, in this case, the hidden line are turned off. I can say, no, I want to see the hidden line as well. So you can press this, yes, if you want the silhouette as well, and you press enter. And now what you have is you have your section along with the background. And now if you look at your section layer organization, the background is organized in other layers and sublayers. So you can just basically readily turn off the background or turn off the hidden lines or the visible lines or, you know, any combination you want. And you can present that. Obviously, you know, when you go to the page layout, you will see that all that is also available to you there. It's the same because it's basically a view on the top view. And but you can turn off and on layers you know, irrespective of it. So this is really a kind of nice way. Obviously, an elevation is basically has to include all the background because there isn't, you're probably cutting through just the earth or the base slab or something. But everything else is drawn as a background lines. But the nice thing is, like I said, you can think of it as make 2D that is dynamically updatable with model changes. You can do the same to extract the plan view or, you know, any other view that you want. That's kind of the new thing, and it's also you can dimension it. You know, like it's all a vector drawing, right? You can start, you know, doing things like that, and you know, snap to it, and you know, those might not change with model changes, but this is the last step, is to be able to use it, and you know, because it's vector drawing, it's going to print at certain quality. People can use it, export it to other programs to render it. Now you have that available.
Hi, Roger. So even with history, the dimensions will not update as you change the sections?
Correct. Right, because now you are really, what you're getting is you're extracting a drawing, so you're extracting a projections. Unless we kind of correlate that dimension point to the model down to the drawing, we cannot any longer have that chain. And if you radically change your clipping a plane or rotate it, you're really going to lose that point. I think it's much easier to associate with history the points on the object itself and the dimension than you do through the drawing. And it is a very, very super challenging problem, programmatically speaking. But this is something to look into because I understand the utility of it. And at least in the general case, maybe this is doable in the simple kind of case. But you can understand, you can probably appreciate the challenge with that kind of thing.
Yeah. Thank you.
I just thought of something that isn't always obvious. And that is, if you decided you didn't want the section or the plan, then you need to delete the layers. So,
not necessarily.
Another way. I mean, that is one way.
Oh, yeah. No, that's a good question. That is an amazing question. But here, let's suppose I really no longer like that section 00 and I don't want it. And it's here. It's the drawing is in layers. It's there in the named views. It's everywhere. How can I get rid of that thing? How can I clean it? What you can do is really just select that particular section and delete it select the widget. That will remove all the layers. It will remove it from the named views. It's remove it from everywhere.
So I added a sphere to this house just in front. It was clipped perfectly, but it was not updated in the section in the drawing.
Great question. And this is also in the layout, as you can see under under six, item six in the exercise six, which is when you move the clipping plane, we immediately know something changed in that section. So everything updates, you know. But if you are starting to add objects to your scene, okay, and you might want to add, you know, quite a bit of objects. You don't want to wait for it, you know, every time you add an object, wait for all the drawings to update and take that new object into account. So it is on purpose actually to wait for you to finish adding and updating the model, adding a new objects, and then you run update the clipping drawings command. And what it does is basically you go and you select that section and say, hey, I finished modeling, I added object, deleted objects. Now I want to update my drawings. I'm ready to wait for it because it could be time consuming. So you run that command and everything is going to update. Just try it now and see if that works for you. The drawing should update, especially if your section is set up to section through all objects, because you can set up your section to section through just layer X, you know? And if you add a million object to layer Y, nothing is gonna happen to the drawing. So yeah, that's like, if you see it clipped by your clipping plane, it should also update with your drawing with using update the clipping drawing command.